Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's look at a reaction that relies on ester enolates, the Claisen condensation. The reaction in the upper middle of the screen is the Claisen condensation. It is the reaction of an ester enolate with another ester. Following protonation of a reaction intermediate, the product is a beta-keto ester. Beta-keto esters are really useful molecules. The Claisen condensation isn't the only way to make them, but it is one of the standard methods. Okay, let's walk through the mechanism. In this reaction, we have an ester and a base. In this case, the base is sodium ethoxide. Note that the R group on the base matches the R group on the ester oxygen. They're both ethyls. These need to match. We'll talk about why in the next video. So the base deprotonates the alpha carbon of the ester to make an enolate. The pKa of esters is pretty high. It's around 25. So the concentration of the enolate will be extremely low. The equilibrium favors the original ester. That means the enolate will form, but the reaction will mostly contain undeprotonated ester. The ester enolate is a nucleophile, and it will attack the ester starting material, an electrophile, to form a tetrahedral intermediate. From the tetrahedral intermediate, we can look for a leaving group. We have one in the ethoxy group. The O- ejects the leaving group, and we get our beta-keto ester. At this point, you might think we're done. I mean, this is the same as the expected product I drew at the top of the screen. Well, we're not quite done. This product does form in the reaction, which happens to be full of base. Beta-keto esters are weakly acidic. These protons between the two carbonyls have a pKa of around 12. Even though we don't want one of them to be deprotonated, sodium ethoxide will remove one of these protons to form a new enolate. This enolate is very stable because the charge can delocalize into two carbonyls. This type of enolate is sometimes called a stabilized enolate. The beta-keto ester in the bottom middle of the screen is an example of something called an active methylene compound. Active methylene compounds have a CH2 between two electron withdrawing groups. The EWGs in this case are carbonyls, but they could also be nitro groups, NO2, or nitriles, CN. Okay, so like it or not, this new enolate, the stabilized enolate, will form. To finish the reaction, we therefore need to add a little bit, in a second step, of acid and water. This will neutralize the reaction, protonate the enolate, and finally we get our beta-keto ester. That is the Claisen condensation. If you put R groups on the alpha carbon of the ester, the deprotonation becomes less favorable. While this reaction might seem to be very limited because of it's hard to put R groups here, the product is very useful for chemistry that we will see in a later playlist.